how does the sound get produced? We saw that there is a vayu which comes and hits the vocal cord, and it gets converted to a dhwani, which is a voiced sound, and then it gets modified by some of the articulators and amplifiers, which is the sthana and prayatna, and then the sound is produced, recognizable sound is produced. This is very, very important. The sound energy is coming from the air pressure. Air pressure is converted to sound energy. If you want to put it in terms of physics or modern science. So the question is, did our ancient scholars know which recognizable sound is produced in which point of articulation? Now you all of us spoke about these 8 points of articulation. Nasika, Murdha, Oshtav, Dantaha, Talu, Kantha, Jihva, Mula, Uraha. Did our ancient scholars know which recognizable sound is produced in which point of articulation? Yes, and that is what is called Shiksha Sutra, and the Shiksha Shastra summarizes that. And this is a table which gives the summary of the sounds which can be produced from through which point of articulation. Now, Kantha is the throat. So you have the letters A, Kavarga letters, K, K, G, G, N, Ha, and Visarga, which are produced from the Kantha. Kantha. Now let us experience this. A, A. You know that it is produced from the sound. All of you try this. I know I can't see your video, but you can try it. A, 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 A. See, A, Ka, 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 Ga. So we are pronouncing it from the Kantha. Similarly, if you come to the soft palate, the letters E, the E family, and the Chavarga, Y, Sha, these are produced from the Talu. Talu is the soft palate. Ch, Ch, J, J, Ny, Y, Sh, E. Now you understood the type of sound is coming from one place. Rutu Rashanam Murdha. Now the letter R, Tavarga, Ta, Tha, Da, Dha, Na, R, Sha, Sha, Sha. Now, the difference between Shakara and Shakara in pronunciation, somebody was asking. Shakara, Shiva, Sha is a Talavya Akshara. The point of articulation for Sha is Talu. The point of articulation of Sha is Murdha. That is why yesterday our panelist Megha Bagini was telling, why don't you roll the tongue? Sha, Sha. So Rutu Rashana Murdha. The hard palate which is there, Ta, you can see the sound going, hitting that hard palate and coming back. Ta, Tha, Da, Dha, N, Ra. This is the experience of Murdha Akshara. Danta, easily experienceable. Ta, T, Th, D, Dh, N, L, S. Suppose somebody does not have teeth, or for temporarily our grandmas and grandpas, if they don't have teeth for some reason, you can ask them to pronounce the Tavarga. They'll find it very difficult and it will be slurred speech. Ta, Tha, Da, Dha, Na, they will not be able to pronounce because the air has to come and stop there. T, Th, D, Dh, N. Okay. Now, this is Dantaha. The teeth also help. The next is Oshtav. This also can be experienced very easily. Ukara and P, P, B, B, M, and the Upadhmaniya. Upadhmaniya are the two visargas by the Ardha Visarga in front of the letter P and Pha. Now, P, P, B, B, M. Suppose I decide to not close my lips. I will let me do an action. You can see the video. I will keep it like this. You see, I will not be able to pronounce the pavarga letters. The ukar also. The moment I do you see how the lips are involved in the pronunciation of ukara and pavarga and the upadhmaniya. Same way, there are a combination of these sthanas which take place when ekara, aikara is there. Kantha and talu are involved. Same way, kantha and oshta is involved in okara and aukara. The nasika, the nasal passages are involved for all the anunasika letters. N, m, y, v, m. And also dantoshta, vakara. Vakara is produced v, 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 danta, oshta. V, v, v. You can see danta and oshta is involved. V, v, vasishtaha, v, v, v. So dantoshtaha, dantoshtam. Jihva Moolam, the Ardha Visarga before the Kakara and Khakara, Jihva Moola is involved. So these are the letters and these are the points of articulation. Now what about the Aurasya Varna? Aurasya Varna I was talking about yesterday. Ha, Hana, Hana, Hua, all these are aurasya varnas, and hna, hva, hma, brahma, hma, these are aurasya varnas, and they come from the chest, slightly from the chest. The chest is also slightly involved along with the other points of articulation. Again, don't think that there is only one point of articulation many times for one letter. Like for example, the letter nakara, makara, yakara and all. Now for the letter nakara, the danta is involved and also the nasal passage. Nasal passage is there behind. That nasal passage, nasal cavity or nasal passage is also involved. Ma, ma, m, m, m. So lips is involved. The nasal passage is involved. This is very, very sukshma. Very, very sukshma. This vichara is very sukshma to be experienced by one and all. And we have to practice this like a yoga shastra. The siksha shastra has to be practiced by pronouncing the letters in front of a trained guru who will train you in this siksha. And then you can pronounce the Vedas and the Sanskrit bhasha. This is how advanced the thinking of our sages and our acharyas, the gurus of the ancient knowledge system. Now, what these gurus did, they gave us sutras, formulas. They said, if you cannot visualize all this, you do one thing, you remember these formulas. To slowly start experiencing this. So they gave some shortcuts. Ku means kavarga, chu means chavarga, tu means tavarga, tu, tavarga, pu, bhavarga. Like this, they gave some abbreviations and they gave us some sutras. I will recite these sutras. I would request Megha Bhagini to recite after me. All of you can recite these sutras. As Megha Bhagini recites. Akuha visarjaniyanam kanthaha.
Akuha visarjaniyanam kanthaha.
Ichu yashanam talu.
Ichu yashanam talu.
Ruturashanam
talu.
Ruturashanam murdha.
Ruturashanam murdha. Ruturashanam murdha.
Ritulasanam dantaha.
Ritulasanam dantaha. Ritulasanam dantaha.
Nyamagananam nasikacha.
न्यमगणनानां नासिका च न्यमगणनानां नासिका च
ये दयितोः कण्ठतालु
ये दयितोः कण्ठतालु ये दयितोः कण्ठतालु
ओदौतोः कण्ठोष्ठम्
ओदौतोः कण्ठोष्ठम् ओदौतोः कण्ठोष्ठम्
वकारस्य दन्तोष्ठम्
वकारस्य दन्तोष्ठम् वकारस्य दन्तोष्ठम्
जिह्वामूलीयस्य जिह्वामूलम्
जिह्वामूलीयस्य जिह्वामूलम् जिह्वामूलीयस्य जिह्वामूलम्
नासिका अनुस्वारस्य
नासिका अनुस्वारस्य नासिका अनुस्वारस्य
I will just work backwards and work out the table from the sutras. Akuha visarjaniyanang kantaha. A refers to all the letters of the A family, which is A hraswaswara, A dirghaswara, which is A plutaswara, which is A. Ku refers to the kavarga letters. K, kh, g, gh, ng, ha. H refers to ha, visarjaniya refers to visarga. So, akuha visarjaniyanam kantaha. Yete varnaha kantyaha iti uchyante. These are called as kantya letters. Those which are articulated from the kanthasthana. Ichu yashanan talu I. Refers to the ikara family, similar to the previous one. E pluta. Chu refers to chavarga. Chu chu ju jhny. Yashanam. Yush. Yashanam talu. Yete varnaha talavyaha iti uchyante. These letters are called as talavya letters. Because they originate, they get articulated from the sthana, talu. Talu is the soft palate. Rutu rashanam murdha. Rikara, dirgha rikara. Ru, pluta luka rikara. Along with tavarga, tdhdhdhnu. Repha, ru, shakara. These rashanam murdha, the hard palate. Yete varnaha murdhanyaha iti uchyante. Ritu lasanam dantaha. L, we know that lkara dirgha is not there. L, pluta, tthdhdhnu. L, S, yete varnaha dantyaha iti uchyante. These are dentals. They come from, they are articulated from the sthana, teeth. U, upupadhmaniyanam oshthau. U, pu. Pu refers to pavarga. Pu, pu, bu, bhum. Upadhmaniya. They are produced. Yete varnaha oshtyaha iti uchyante. These are labials. They are originated from the lips. Yedaitoho kantathalu. So yet and ait. Ye refers to ye dirgha, ye pluta, ai dirgha, ai pluta. Kantathalu. Kantha talavyaha yete varnaha. O pluta. O is dirga. O pluta. Au dirga. Au pluta. Kantoshthyaha. Similarly, we have nasika letters. Nya, nyamagana nana. Nya, nyam. Nya, 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 nya. These letters. Nya, ny, n, m. the anunasika letters, the fifth letters of the varga, anuswara, y with the dot, with the chandra bindu, y, these varnas are called as nasika letters. Anunas, they take the help of nasal passage for articulation. Dantoshtha. Vakarasya dantoshtham. Jihvamuliyasya jihvamulam. Jihvamuliya is ardhavisarga before ka and kha. Is jihvamulam. This is how we can get the table from the sutra. The sutra can be extracted from the table. Whatever we want to do, we can do. I was just curious after I was preparing for this class. I was just curious as to see how modern science tells that sound is produced. Now that we have cameras, we have videos that can be taken. Medical videos are there, etc. So I was just curious how sound is produced as per modern science. There was a website called voicefoundation.org. I just referred to that website and saw if our Shastra and our modern science are matching. You see, this is the question which our young children will ask. Sir, in modern science, this is how it is. I'm sure there are doctors in this class who can confirm what the ancient science and the modern science, how their thoughts are matching. So the modern science, as per this website, voicefoundation.org, they have done a lot of research on how the voice is produced. A column of air pressure is moved towards the vocal cords, and that air is moved out of the lungs and towards the vocal cords by the coordinated action of the diaphragm, abdominal muscles, chest muscles, and the ribcage. Now, the modern science here does not talk about the kayagni, and it does not talk about atma buddhi manas sanyoga. Now, you see how our ancient rishis had advanced thinking. They said the ichha to produce sound should be there. If somebody wants to have a mauna vrata on Ekadashi day and you ask him to produce sound, he is not going to produce sound. A sage who is going to do penance in the forest, he is not going to produce sound. So the ichha should be there. Now here there is a slight difference. They have started from this place. A column of air pressure is moved towards the vocal cords, and the coordinated action of the diaphragm wall, the abdominal muscles, chest muscles, ribcage happens, and there is a sequence of vibratory cycles that happen. The modern science describes that the sound which is produced as a vibratory sound, which is probably the raw sound. And then they say through the Bernoulli effect or the air pressure is converted into the sound waves. That is through that when the air passes through the vocal cords. Now, after this happens, the rapid pulse of air that is created by the repeated vibratory cycles produce something called voiced sound, and this is amplified by what the modern science call as vocal tract resonators and vocal tract articulators, which modify into recognizable voice. This is exactly matching to our ancient shastra, siksha shastra. So what they call it as sthana and prayatna are these points of articulation, and the amplification also takes place. So yada shabda prayoga ichha bhavati tada kayagnina nabhi pradeshat preritaha pranavayuhu urdhvam akraman murdha paryantam gatva pratinivartate pratinivruttaha saha vayuhu mukham prapya kantadi sthanani ahatya varnan abhivyanakti tataha sayeva vayuhu gala vivara vikasadin karoti evancha jihvagra madhya mulaihi kantadi sthana bighatartham gala vivara vikasadyartham cha vayoho sahayabhuta kriya prayatnaha iti uchyate. This is the how the effort is defined in ancient science, which is nothing but what the modern science also tells. So people who want to study the Siksha Shastra can study this and understand this better. Now, why is this important? This entire Siksha Shastra, these points of articulation, etc. Why is this important? Because the science of phonetics, the science of sound, is very important for understanding the changes which get produced in the sound, which is nothing but the sandhi, which we'll be talking in the next class. So for this, we require these sounds. This finishes this portion of the class. This was a long session, but it is a very useful session, and it is to some extent we have covered the basics of how sound is produced.